Man down. There is a man down on your street this evening. He got knocked down. No, not by a drunk driver or hit and run. He got run down by you. He's the man you told to man up yesterday. There's a man down in your church, in your mosque, in your office, in your neighborhood, in your cities, in your country, yes, under your very nose. You just shot a man down. You just shot him down with your unreasonable standards and your inhumane requests and your honest feedback when you told him to man up. Man up, man, man up. Why are you so emotional? Why are you talking like a woman? Nobody cares about your feelings. You know, do these all sound familiar? I'm sure they do. You know, all of us at some point or the other have, you know, obviously said this to a man who exhibited a behavior that in our estimation was less than manly. This begs the question, who is a man? You know, or what is man? You know, a question that has begged answers for centuries and produces as many answers almost as there are men. You know, hunter, gatherer, provider, fighter. No, these are the most earliest, you know, definitions. But hey, thank God. You know, man has evolved, right? We have upgraded to, you know, macho, you know, head of the home, alpha male, protector, buff, you know. But have we really evolved? You know, well, the man has evolved from the half-naked, hide-wearing, club-wielding caveman to the alpha male, you know, gentleman in blue blazers and khaki pants. But humor this thought for a minute. Today's man is actually dying under more pressure and takes his life out of this weight more than any time in history, ironically. So I know what you're thinking. Are there no badly behaved men? You know, is this a case for bad behavior, abuse, or male chauvinism? Oh, no, absolutely not. I'm not that naive. Let me try and put this in perspective. You know, some statistics might help us. You know, so globally, you know, male suicide rate is almost 3 times the female. The suicide rate in men can be as much as 10 times higher than for women in some countries. You know, Nigeria has the highest rate of suicide in Africa, with men leading the numbers. In England, around 1 in 8 men has a common mental health problem, such as depression, anxiety, panic disorder, or OCD, you know, what we call obsessive-compulsive disorder. You know, men aged 40 to 49 have the highest suicide rates. Men report lower levels of life satisfaction than women, according to the government's National Wellbeing Survey. You know, men are less likely to access, you know, psychological therapies than women. It's 70% of rough sleepers are men. Does your husband snore? You know. Men are nearly 3 times as likely as women to become dependent on alcohol and 3 times as likely to report frequent drug use. Men make up the vast majority of the prison population. There are high rates of mental health problems and increasing rates of self-harm in prisons. Why don't men talk about, you know, mental health? Societal expectations and traditional gender roles play a role in why men are less likely to discuss or seek help in their mental health problems. It's important to understand that men can be damaged by stereotypes and expectations as well. So what do we do? I say catch them young. We must immediately begin to ask the question, what kind of boys are we raising today? These boys will soon become men, and their success and or failure will be determined by what we teach them today, actually what we teach them now. Many boys grow up today with a wrong composition. You know, they're just products of conflicting and contradicting information from fathers, mothers, brothers, sisters, you know, uncles, aunties, friends. You know, just like many men today grew up with the wrong composition years ago without even knowing it. So what about the older men, you say? We must start getting rid of our stereotypes, you know, right away and start giving them a chance to speak. So basically be an ear or be a shoulder to a man, encourage men to open up. By doing so, you might just be saving the life of another man down. Mm. All right.
What scary statistics.
I know, right?
Do you know that 4 in 5 men that I know, and this is not even pulling numbers from the sky, are on BP medication?
Yeah.
Right? Because everything is suppressed. You're not allowed to speak out. Yeah, you're not allowed to show emotions. Mm, yeah. And for me, the scary part is there's actually a knock-on effect in the home because you've raised men that are emotionally bankrupt, so they're not able to feel the emotions that their home requires, love, empathy, support, kindness, because they're supposed to be stoic and strong. Mm-hmm. So it doesn't even benefit anyone at the end of the day. Yeah. The man is depressed. The man is very stressed. He ends up on medication, mm-hmm. right? Then he takes it out on his family and repeats the cycle all over again.
Exactly.
It is scary. It's not attractive. I think it's so old school. It's not attractive to say that men should not show emotions. Why not? You've lost someone. It's okay to cry. Yeah. It doesn't make you any less of who you are.
Yeah.
You know, yes, you show emotions and then you move to action because ultimately there's a problem, it needs to be solved.
Yeah.
But it doesn't make you any less of who you are. And we really need to stop the stereotype, you know, which is actually sometimes coming from women, right? The expectations from women that he's a sissy because he showed emotion.
Yeah.
We see that all the time, you know, even on TV. It's like, why is he crying? Act like a man. And you are correct. That's man down.
That's one down, absolutely.
And like I even saying, it even goes beyond the emotion. I mean, like saying the women bit, some say, oh, he's not man enough. How much does he have? How much does he earn? And this man is already working like 10 hours in a day. I mean, and the thing is, he doesn't have the support that will mold them to discover a better him. You know, some men will marry women that will tell them, oh, what you're doing, you could do it this way, that way, that way. And the man changes and is making more money. But some women will just run them down. But it even goes beyond that again. I think we are not facing the realities of our time. We're still applying what was given in the days like years ago, in the olden days. We're applying it to this modern time where everything has changed. Back then, the needs were less. The expectation was just for you to get married, go to the farm, come back home. But now there's so much that is being demanded of you. You have the bad economy, you have so many things to grapple with, and to even add salt to injury, if you're a fan of Arsenal, that's even a love question. You haven't won any cup in a long time. You know, so yes, I think you're very right. There are these little things we do have an effect, a ripple effect on every other aspect of life, from work to home, even to religion. Because a pastor now that is depressed will get to the pulpit and tell everybody, better believe God or you die, and will preach some kind of sermons, or an imam will act in a way. So yes, man down is something we all need to look at.
These things usually start from when children are really little. So I have a son, and when maybe he falls or something, I remember we had a nanny then, and she would say, why are you crying? Stop crying. You're a man. And I told her, no, stop, please. Let him cry. He's hurt. Let him express how he feels.
Absolutely.
He's still a child.
Yes.
Let him cry. He's allowed to.
Yeah.
The fact that he's a boy does not make him
superhero.
Not feel pain.
Exactly.
You understand? Yes. He has to feel pain and express that.
His arms won't grow back when you cut them off.
Exactly. There's blood. He needs to express that, oh, this is.
Yeah.
So I think it starts from how little they are. I wouldn't tell a child, don't cry. You need to cry, especially for boys. Cry. It's okay to cry. Let them understand that they have these emotions and it's very important for them to express it.
Absolutely.
If they have something, you see some who say, ah, this man talks too much. That's his way of expressing himself.
Absolutely.
If he doesn't talk, he's going to suppress things.
Absolutely.
And it's going to come out in a completely different way that you wouldn't like or appreciate. So the earlier we begin to have that conversation and encourage our men, our brothers, our husbands, our uncles, our dads, if there's an issue, if you notice something and they're shielded, their way of dealing with it is just to be on their own. You can reach out to them and lend our voices to them.
Allow them to speak up. Absolutely.
Exactly.
And you know, you just nailed it on the head by saying expression, because an emotion, and Uche said emotion, expression, you know, the same thing, more or less, same size of a coin. Because, you see, one of the things that separates a human really from an animal is emotion and expression. It's one of the things that makes us different. And humans were built for expression and emotion. So from that little age, I mean, for most young boys, the first thing they ever hear growing up is, why are you crying? Be a boy, be a man, are you a girl, right? And the moment you start to do that, you're starting to stifle his expression from when he's that young. And it takes, and it's the thing with humans is, humans will express themselves. It's the nature of humans to express themselves. So that expression will come out. You just need to ask yourself, do you want it positively or negatively?
Or negative. And comfort, how are you expressing yourself from Abuja?
In a conflicted, I'm conflicted about this one.
Exactly.
I would like to see my man take charge. I'm sorry. I don't want to see tears. He can do that inside the house.
Comfort.
I'm a bit conflicted about this, but I agree with you absolutely that the man now is also in a very precarious position currently. But I think that both the females and the males are culprits here. So you have women now who have more power, more ability to express themselves, more desires, more wants, more vanity. And then you have men who determine their self-worth by their sexual prowess and by their financial ability. So you have this woman on this side who has this power, this man who wants to meet up also. So there's also the pressure within, and we're not being honest anymore. We're not being honest. So so at this point, especially with the current situation, there would need to be a lot of unlearning, even for the adult male population now, that look, you can't kill yourself because your woman wants to wear 250K hair per week, just so that you too, you, the man, too, can fit into a certain social circle. But you see, if you have to go, if the man has to go down that route, he needs to assume a certain position. But the current narrative on the side of the woman is that she's not supposed to be listening to any man telling her, no, 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 and she too is supposed to express herself. So we're messing with the order of things, then there's the continual conflict. And so both parties just keep on doing what they want to do, trying to find a middle ground for peace. I had a male follower reach out to me and say, when he was getting married, he needed to talk to men, just any older man, like the way women do. You know, women have, well, that's what helps us. We like to gossip. So we have groups of friends that we gossip with, we tell everything. So in a manner of speaking, we unburden ourselves and then we're able to do it. But men don't do that. What they do when they meet in their gatherings is usually to talk about Arsenal, as you said, Chelsea, and the new drink in town or the new babe in town, not the core issues. So I think that's another part that guys have to, when you come together, it's not about the superficial issues, but talk to yourselves.
We should stop feeling ashamed.
Comfort, absolutely agree with you. But I mean, we're almost out of time now. Thank you, Comfort. Fantastic feedback right there. So Uche is next after the break. Please don't go anywhere.